The Public Finance Management Act Amendment Bill of 2021 seeks to amend Section 57 of the Act to insert new clauses which allow Uganda National Oil Company to retain the proceeds from the sale of petroleum products to meet its obligation arising from applicable petroleum agreements without parliamentary approval. This, according to experts, is sapping parliamentary powers of appropriation.
We need to set a red line on appropriation because that is our primary mandate. And anything that threatens that role basically touches on the independence of the judiciary, of Parliament, and Parliament is representing the people of Uganda. So I think we need to look at these amendments very closely.
Why do we have members of Parliament? They have three specific things: appropriation, oversight, and registration. So now you are telling members of Parliament to legislate and remove appropriation and oversight. That's what this bill is. So we are saying, fine, we understand UNOC very well, that you are a commercial entity of government, you need to make very quick decisions, but you must have a plan. You must estimate that this financial year I will need 1 trillion Ugandan shillings.
UNOC can't be greater than the government of Uganda. We appropriate to various ministries of this country. Yesterday we sat late. I left my members, still looking at the supplementaries which were flowing in. I think they must have left at 9 p.m. Budget Committee marathon, looking at supplementaries for government. I think total is over 3 trillion shillings.
During a meeting with members of Parliament on the Committee of Finance and Budget, Julius Mukunda, the Executive Director of CSBUG, noted with concern that allowing UNOC a leeway to collect revenue and keep it outside Consolidated Fund and the Petroleum Fund and spend it at source without approval from Parliament will expose oil revenue to misuse.
It means that UNOC will spend on travel abroad, will spend on buying vehicles, will spend on increasing their salaries, will spend on meeting other tariff obligations, other investments, without parliamentary approval. It is dangerous.
It's total madness. So I don't know the objectives of the people bringing it, because there is no way you can convince the nation that you're giving this company, the Uganda National Oil Company, all the rights to manage our income from the oil, and they give us the balance. We are seeing very many government entities, including even Bank of Uganda, declaring losses year in, year out. So what guarantee do we have that these people will not declare losses as well and bring nothing to our consolidated fund?
The amendment bill, which is currently before the Parliamentary Committee of Finance, makes the oil company only answerable to its board and the cabinet regarding approval of investments. Experts believe cabinet and the board are not sufficient enough to guarantee effective oversight and controls.
Why you want to put a strong oversight on that is that UNOC will have its liberty to do anything that has not been appropriated. And when I say anything, it means that it can even be beyond their investments. It might be things that actually might not bring returns to government.
When we have such insights from willing partners, we need to take note and interrogate further. We compare. But I want to tell you that is possible that even the people who believe that this is a bad law can be convinced to believe that it is a good law.
The civil society organization advocacy group CSBUG has called for a Uganda Revenue Authority model where the agency is allowed to spend revenue at source, but specifically on items approved by Parliament in financial year budget.
When we got this proposal, I was left perplexed, wondering how, because coming from a background of business where even small business owners are discouraged from spending at source, I now wonder how UNOC profiles itself in a way that it can't foresee its annual expenditure.
Clause 1 of the bill proposes to revise the definition of petroleum revenue, which is raising eyebrows over the civil society. According to them, if the bill is enacted, proceeds from sale of petroleum arising out of state participating interest in the applicable petroleum agreements will not form part of petroleum revenue.
We feel that the bill undermines greatly the public finance management safeguards are put in place for people not to misuse money.
Story by Fred Kajubi for the news.